Sing praise to our God, all you who fear God, both small and great, for now salvation and strength have come, and the power of Christ. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. We're called to rejoice in good times and in bad, in rainy days as well as sunny days. Please join me in offering this Mass for Will Fraser as a first anniversary memorial. Will died in the early days of the pandemic. We also pray for a member of our daily Mass community, Rose Colucci, who's in the hospital, and my stepfather, Dan Tebear, who's undergoing surgery on his hand later this morning. For these and for all those who have asked our prayers, we will bring these up in the prayers of the faithful. Yesterday, because of the feast, we missed the part of the Acts of the Apostles that we have a little bit of comic relief, where Barnabas and Paul are confused with Greek gods because of the healing that they performed. Today's readings are much less comical, as Paul is stoned for his faith, for his connection and acceptance and following of Christ. Let us ask God's mercy and grace in our lives so that we may endure sufferings and remain faithful to him. Let us ask the forgiveness of God for our sins to make us more worthy to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, grant your people constancy in faith and hope, that we may never doubt the promises of which we have learned from you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, some Jews from Antioch and Iconium arrived and won over the crowds. They stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing that he was dead. But when the disciples gathered around him, he got up and he entered the city. On the following day, he left with Barnabas for Derbe. After they had proclaimed the good news to that city and made considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra in Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in the faith, saying, "It is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God." They appointed presbyters for them in each church, and with prayer and fasting commended them to the Lord, in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through Pisidia and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the word at Perga, they went down to Attalia. From there, they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. When they arrived, they called the church together and reported what God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. Then they spent no little time with the disciples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your friends make known. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. Your friends. May my mouth speak the praise of the Lord, and may all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
To suffer and to rise from the dead, and so enter into his glory. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away, and I will come back to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe. I will no longer speak much with you, for the ruler of the world is coming. He has no power over me, but the world must know that I love the Father, and that I do just as the Father has commanded me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you. Christ. Those longer responses to the psalm are more difficult when we don't have a hymnal or worship aid in front of us. I kept slipping this morning from saying, "Your friends make known the splendor of your kingdom," to "Your works make known the splendor of your kingdom." Because so often the praise is of God and God's works. But today, the psalm response invites us to see how God's friends are an active part of his making known the splendor of his kingdom. Saul, whom we know as Saint Paul, was anything but a friend of the Lord at first, persecuting the church, participating and condoning the stoning of Saint Stephen and other faithful disciples of the Lord, until he was literally knocked off his horse. And today, Paul experiences in our first reading another calamity, more vicious than being knocked off his horse and blinded temporarily. He's stoned practically to death. Just as he had been judged by the early church, he was now being judged by faithful Jews, perhaps those who were unwilling to see Jesus as the Messiah. And he was left for dead. But through the friends of God gathered around him, the disciples gathered around him, he was able to get up and enter back into the city where he had been stoned. I don't know about you, but I think I would have gone in a different direction. On the following day, they did. Barnabas and Paul left for Derbe. He must have had black eyes and bruises all over his body. And yet he continued to proclaim the good news. If I were a citizen in Derbe, I would say, "This is good news. You're not looking very well." And again, if I was Paul after visiting Derbe, I would go directly back. I don't think I would want to make a stop at the places where I had proclaimed the good news and show off my wounds. But he did. Very Christ-like, if you think about it. Showing his wounds so that they too would know the cost of discipleship. It's not all easy going, but Jesus is with us in the good times and the bad. In the face of that kind of suffering, it might seem hard to believe Jesus' promise in the gospel, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you." There are times of peace, and there are times of disturbance. There are times of joy and times of suffering. That's the kind of peace the world gives. But Jesus does not give peace in the way the world does. His peace is much deeper than a freedom from sufferings or disturbance of our tranquility. No, his peace is much deeper. The peace of knowing God with us, even in the midst of our earthly sufferings. Jesus, going to the Father, says, "The ruler of this world is coming. He has no power over me. But the world must know that I love the Father and that I do just as the Father has commanded me." Jesus himself asked to be spared the suffering of the cross, but always followed his prayers with, "Thy will be done." May we too rely on that deeper peace in our lives that endures not only tranquility, but times of disturbance and suffering in our lives, helping us to trust in him, to find that grace we need, to even be willing to be known by our scars, like the one whom we follow. Strengthened in our faith, let us offer prayers together for the church and all peoples of the world.
For our leaders in the church, that they may strengthen the spirits of Christ's disciples and exhort them to persevere in the faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that Jesus' farewell gift to us may stand guard over our hearts and enable us to be a leaven of peace in the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may not allow our hearts to be troubled or afraid, no matter what trial or persecution may come, but trust in Jesus through everything that happens in our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need of prayer, especially the poor, the sick, the imprisoned, and the addicted, and those who are grieving the loss of a loved one, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, that they may be introduced into the glorious splendor of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Particularly, we pray for Will Frazier, for whom this is a first anniversary memorial, and for Rose and for Dan and all those seeking medical care and treatment. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the many ways that you strengthen us in times of peace and tranquility and in times of trouble. Help us to continue to trust in you, no matter what our circumstances, for you are faithful. And we ask these prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and ask the intercession of his mother, our blessed mother, as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
Mm.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martha, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Will, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another some sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. If we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with Christ. Alleluia.
On behalf of those joining us by video, we pray the prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you. Oh, it's the prayer group tonight, right? Yes, so the Mary Garden prayer meeting is this evening. You're all invited to join in person or online at 7:30 here at St. Mary Church in Wrentham. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Regina Celi, letare, alleluia. Quiamque meruis deportare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sic ut dixit, alleluia. Ora pro